There she is. Yes, train 691 arriving in April. And route to Brunswick. We're going on it. These Z-Bells are horrible. Oh, this is northbound. And we have the dome car. Even better.
Is that the one we're getting on?
No, that's northbound.
No, but I mean, we're going to take a dome back, right?
Yeah.
What number? 696.
696. We got 9213. Good one. Take care.
Wells, is your stop. Please make your way back into the body of the train and locate a member of the crew, because that's where the exits are going to be. Wells Main now arriving. We'll be arriving in Wells. If you're getting off in Wells, we'll be here in a minute, so please depart now. If you're getting off in Wells, depart now.
As I said, we'll be arriving in Wells.
Chicago and Seattle, Washington.
And so the train was going back and forth, Chicago to Seattle, back and forth. And eventually, when Amtrak came along in 1971, and later decided that they were going to hook this great dome car onto the auto train, Lloyd, Virginia to Santa Florida, outside of Orlando. And that's a 16-hour train ride. Lloyd, Virginia, outside of Potomac, Washington, D.C., 30 miles east of Orlando, what on the. But anyway, it was on for like 6 years, and then Amtrak decided to allow the other Amtrak routes to be able to get this great dome car hooked up on. So we're lucky to have it. We had it since October 19th, and tomorrow, unfortunately, will be our last day. This great dome car, as it has been in past years, will be going to Albany, New York, and at that point, they're going to hook up this great dome car onto the Adirondack train, which runs from New York City to Albany, to Pittsburgh, and then into Montreal. This great dome car, because of its height, cannot go south of Albany. And so that's